If you've got a traditional centralized database and somebody wants to hack in and alter some record to their benefit and presumably somebody else's disadvantage, like saying that I own some piece of property, not whoever the record originally said, once they can get through, if they can get through the cryptographic security around that, once they get in, they simply go in and change that file, change that record. That's the way it works today, if you're not on the blockchain. If you're on the blockchain, it's a little bit different because you go in, you could find that file, but if you change that record, now all the cryptographic mathematic algorithms to tie all those files on the blockchain together, none of them are right. It's an invalid blockchain. It won't be recognized by any of the other copies of the blockchain out there. You have to change every single record of the hundreds or thousands of millions of records on the blockchain in order to be able to have a valid version of the blockchain. You have to rewrite the whole thing. Oh, and you don't do it just at the one place you hack in. You have to hack into every single one of the tens of thousands of nodes on the blockchain and successfully change the records on all of them. And you better be quick, because the blockchain synchronizes every 10 minutes. So you have exactly 9 minutes to hack into, break through the cryptographic security of each and every one of tens of thousands of computers all over the world, and then completely rewrite all those copies of the blockchain identically. One physicist has estimated that the amount of energy required to drive the amount of computing power that would be required to hack into all of those nodes and rewrite all of those blockchains identically within 10 minutes' time is roughly equal to the amount of energy emitted during the same period of time by the sun. So, is it impossible to hack the blockchain? Well, theoretically, no. But from an economic perspective, it's not a very good use of resources. There are better ways to steal from people than trying to hack in the blockchain. Now, having said all of this, I will warn you that, like any technology, people can be stupid about how they implement it and use it. And if you set it up wrong, people can work around the unhackable parts of the blockchain to still figure out ways to steal money from you and other assets and so forth. So it doesn't mean, well, just because we're doing it on the blockchain, we don't have to think about security or controls anymore. You will still have to do that.